Do you own your URL?
Yes.
Good. That's good. Because it's like one thing that I tell girls like right away when they get in the industry is like buy your own domain name because somebody else will and they'll try to sell it to you for like a shit ton of money.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not good.
It's not worth it.
What would be like the one piece of advice that you would give to a new girl in the industry with all of everything that you've learned over the last like year and a half?
I would say make sure that this is something that you want to do and commit. Before you dive in, and, you know, just take the time to think about it and know what you're getting yourself into, and also make a financial plan. Don't throw away your money. Save your money.
Wow.
You know,
that's such a solid advice and something that a lot of girls don't, because a lot of these people come from making absolutely nothing to all of a sudden making a lot of money in a short period of time. And they forget that like work's going to kind of drop off a little bit after like you've been shut, you know, after you're not the new thing
Do
anymore.
Your taxes.
Oh my God.
File
do your
taxes.
Taxes.
Do your taxes. And also, you know, don't take as much write off and try to buy a house, work on your credit and, you know, try to. If you're going to do this, you have to be business-minded about it. So, like, when you get a check, don't spend it on shoes.
Yeah.
Have someone else buy your shoes. Hint, hint.
You are so smart.
I would like some new shoes.
Amazon wish list. Exactly. But, you know what? That's so true. I mean, I can't tell you how many, like, documents I get from the IRS telling me to put liens on girls' income because they don't pay their taxes.
Wow.
I get them all the time. I know exactly
girls
who's
that
not.
You shoot?
Yep, I know exactly who's not paying their taxes.
No way.
Yeah, because the IRS will send.
They send you forms.
Yes, because what they do is they look for anybody that the girl has ever been paid from, and then they send, and it's kind of embarrassing. So, like, girls, you really need to pay your taxes.
Whoa.
So they send out letters to all anybody who's ever hired you saying this person, they'll say exactly how much that person owes the IRS.
Wow.
And they say you are not to pay them. If you hire them again, you're not to pay them what you owe them. You're to pay the money to the IRS.
The IRS.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, they don't mess around.
No, they don't. Around. And honestly, like, so back in the day when, so my parents obviously were around, they were shooting porn, you know, in the 70s, 80s, 90s, and they were around, during, the time that the government was trying to make porn illegal. Wow. And they were like there was a famous case called the Freeman case where they tried to say that porn was pimping and pandering. It was the same as prostitution. And so they were able to prosecute under that. Now they lost, but, at the time,
Thank God.
The porn industry was being seriously harassed. Now, when they couldn't get you, and I remember they went after Ginger Lynn because my mom had to testify for her. So if they couldn't get you like an obscenity, they would go after you for taxes.
Wow.
And that's what they do. And that's what they do with like the mafia too. They go after you for like tax evasion. So it's like they can't, you know, so like, especially when you work in like an industry that maybe
wild.
The government's not so friendly with, you want to.
When's her movie coming out?
I don't know. We got to write the script first.
Yes.
But so definitely pay your taxes.
Wow.
I mean, I know some girls that like owe like $200,000-$300,000 in taxes.
Yeah, that's insane.
Like, they have never paid their taxes in their life.
Wow.
And they're like in their 30s.
Yeah.
Like, you're just.
Like, where are you headed?
What are you doing?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Waiting for a hero.
I know, right?
That's one thing. Just one more piece of advice. Like, no one is going to save you. You have to save yourself.
Yes.
You know, so you are your own business person.
Yes.
You have ventured. If you do get into the industry, you got to set up an LLC and you've got to treat it as though you are a business owner.
Absolutely.
You are an independent business owner.
Absolutely.
Not many people take it that seriously.
No, they really don't.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, wise words from Nicolette Shea.
Well,
you should give bookkeeping.
I waited a while. If I had gotten in the industry when I was 21, you know, I probably wouldn't have known what I was doing. But now I'm in a position where I can kind of say a little bit, I'm not perfect, but, you know, this is what I've learned.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
And hopefully, I really want to get into real estate. I want to buy more property and, you know, start.
That's definitely a big thing.
Yeah.
I mean, that's, you know, a great way to.
In Vegas.
Yeah.
In Vegas, we're getting the Raiders.
Yes, I heard about that.
Yeah, I'm super excited.
So you think the real estate market's going to boom?
It's projected to. Yeah. And then we're probably, well, it already has like 10% mm-hmm. in the last year. Mm-hmm. But it's probably going to go up a little bit more this year. And then they're saying next year it's going to level out a bit. And then, but you know, throughout these ups and downs, it's just important to kind of have your reserves.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so that you don't fall into foreclosure.
Right.
And then sell when it's high.
Yeah.